All right, welcome back. Just kicking off hour two here. You're watching Liquid Lunch on Biz TV. I'm John Tobacco, joined by my co-host Frank Morano. And we got a little time for just you and I right here, my friend.
Just you and I.
Just you
just
and
the two
I.
Of us. How nice.
Sharing love together.
That's very cool. All right, well, there's a ton of interesting things in the news. As we were chatting about off air, we were talking about this controversy involving Mrs. Butterworth and Aunt Jemima. Now, I can understand Aunt Jemima, how some people may view this as racially insensitive. And they did reform Aunt Jemima 30 years ago. She used to have, she's modeled after a former slave from the 1890s, and she used to look pretty much like her. And then 30 years ago, they remodeled her to give her pearls and things like that. But Mrs. Butterworth, I don't think it's clear at all. That's Mrs. Butterworth right there. I don't think it's clear at all that this is supposed to be a stereotypical black
woman. Yeah, hold it up
to
this camera.
Yeah,
check.
Okay.
Just put it, go over to this camera.
But, okay, well, whatever. Oh, okay. So, but let's say she is supposed.
What's wrong with that camera?
Let's say Mrs. Butterworth is supposed to be black, which I'm not at all clear that she is. And I just watched a Geico commercial that featured Mrs. Butterworth during the commercial, and she sounded, you know, like she had kind of a waspy accent. I mean, no offense to the wasps out there or any
other. Well, don't get all the wasps going now. That's the last
anyway,
thing. They're going to call their cousins the murder hornets, and they're going to come back, and we got major problems.
But let's say Mrs. Butterworth is, and I'd be curious to hear from some of our black viewers. And if you happen to be black, I'd love to hear from you. You can email me at morano@nycradio.com.
I think the bottle is brown.
Well, but
I mean, syrup's brown.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, she looks like she could be a pilgrim.
Yeah,
the lady.
I don't really see. Let's say she is black. How is that offensive? I mean, is
you would
she,
think you would want an equal amount of syrups to be black,
right,
white. Where are the white syrups?
Right, you heard that with Barbie for a while. When there were no black Barbies or Asian Barbies, people were saying, oh, it's not right that there's no, you know, black Barbie. You wouldn't think all the mascots of food should be like Mr. Peanut, who's clearly a patrician Englishman, or the Kool-Aid guy, who's clearly a California surfer. I mean, let's say Mrs. Butterworth is black. How is that offensive?
Yeah.
And I'm not being provocative. I'm genuinely asking the question.
It's a real question. And if that is offensive, I'm half Irish. What about the Lucky Charms guy? Let's get him off the box of Lucky Charms. Magically delicious.
Well, you know, it's funny that you say that, because James O'Keefe did that in college. He tried to lead a protest as a joke in opposition
what
to Lucky Charms.
What about Chef Boyardee?
Well,
what about Chef Boyardee, the little Italian guy with the mustachio?
Well, he was a real person.
But Chef Boyardee is a real person?
He was, yeah. He died, but yes.
But wasn't Aunt Jemima a real? Didn't you say it was modeled after a real person?
No, well, yes, it was. But her name wasn't Aunt Jemima.
Oh,
Chef Boyardee's name was Chef Boyardee.
Ah,
you know.
But that's not a likeness of him.
It is.
It is?
Yeah.
That's actually the guy, Chef Boyardee.
The only difference is he spelled his name
with an I.
That's right. Yeah. So you know. Don't pretend like you're dumber than you are. And more bad news for...
I didn't think I could pretend I'm dumber than I am.
Bad news for Thomas Jefferson and George Washington. Two California schools named for Washington and Jefferson are going to be renamed. So the fellow that wrote the Declaration of Independence and delineated so clearly that all humans are endowed by their creator with a right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness, his name's off of school.
Gone, like Gone with the Wind. But Gone with the Wind, I hear, is making a comeback. And they're going to edit out the racially insensitive
part. They're going to change the ending to make sure the North wins the Civil War this time.
I've been saying this for a while. The white Anglo male is under attack in America, and this has been happening for a while, way before this. Armin Brot's going to be here right after this. He's a men's rights analyst, and he's the author of The New Father, A Dad's Guide to the Toddler Years. We'll take a quick break, come back right after this.